But this was the first thing you had to take care of. Now the first police here on the diggings, interestingly enough, were Aboriginal. They brought in the native police corps to look after the business. And that's their dwelling there, that's just over the other side. That's called a Maya Maya. Oh, there's one of the policemen there. How are you, sir? He's in there having a bit of a rest. Anyway, he's not giving us much. Anyway. Now it didn't take too long here on the Ballarat, and the gold actually started to run out, believe it or not. That easy gold, all of a sudden they're digging down and they're not getting as much. There were still whispers going on though, the Bendigo and all those other places further north of here, they were all still finding gold and there were some new finds. So most people picked up their wheelbarrow, well they lifted up the handles of it at least, and trundled off, they took off. So most people left the Ballarat Gold Rush. By Christmas of 1851, there were only a couple of hundred left here. They thought it was all over. Well, that's it. News had to get all the way back to Europe and the Americas. So we're not talking about this modern day way of using pigeons and that for getting information around the place. No. Did that, they dug down here and through this whole valley, they found the jewellery shops of Ballarat. That's what it was to be known as. More gold than they could believe, and the quality of the gold turned out to be second to none in the world. So Ballarat's gold turned out to be, even for the whole of Victoria, we were the best. Can you believe it? So. But there are a lot of things that are going to go wrong, all right? It's all very well to have your gold digger's license and to go dig with the gold, but it's a bit of a romantic notion, I've got to tell you. Thank you.
the gold, yeah. Yeah, most definitely. Most definitely, every day we can find gold in here. Every morning.
Look after your friends if they are sick or injured.